What's good, people? About to get a subscriber game going on. Get this guy right here. As you can see, his record is 471-21. Ha, let's see how this goes. I'm about to get my feelings hurt. I know it. I'm about to get my feelings hurt badly. Alright, everybody want to accept this match here. Gah, I'm about to get my feelings hurt. I feel it. To be one of the matches, I get my feelings hurt from everybody. I know. Never said I was the best person. Never said that. Let's go. Hey, man. Good Lord, man. All star. Okay. All right, here we go. Going to Brooklyn, okay. Very respectable team. All right, here we go. Man, could level up with the game invites. Wish me luck. Hopefully I can contain Joe Johnson and Darren Williams. He's put, okay. All right, here we go. Subscriber game. Creme de la creme underscore 7. Let's go. Don't hurt me too bad. Don't hurt me too bad. No, don't do it. Don't hurt me too bad. 2K Sports. Alongside Mark Kellogg and Steve Kerr, this is Kevin Harlan. We're live at Rose. Are you about to jump already? Where the Trailblazers have the home court advantage. They're pretty rattled right now after a road trip in which they did not win a game. Now they hope to get back on track here at home.
Well, they face these guys just once more after tonight. And since they dropped the first game to them earlier, I think
all right, there we go. We just started out. Confidence
going, and then obviously to have a chance to win the season series.
Yeah, I think they'll have a little bungee cord in their step, a little extra bounce and elasticity. They do not want to lose back-to-back games.
We'll take them. We'll take them.
Especially having only one more game to play against them this season.
So the next starting five.
Johnson, Walls, and Humphries are the 2-3 and 4 in order. Brook Lopez is out there with Darren Williams.
We'll take Crash taking them three. We'll take them. We'll take them. Much as I like him as a player, we'll take them. Oh my God, he'll get some help. Roaming the paint.
Williams gets the bucket. Great move to get to the bucket and lay that one in. He's got the softest touch around the basket. Impressive.
You know, when the Nets made the trade for Darren Williams a few seasons ago, Kevin,
there we
they
go.
Were thought to have made
Let's
a
go.
Steal of a deal.
You're right.
Got a little rhythm going on here.
It was a pretty steep price to pay.
Humphries with a screen on Matthews. Off the screen.
We'll take Gerald Wallace shooting now. We'll take him shooting now.
Mid-range shot is not the easiest one to make. When you've got daylight like he had there, I mean, those are shots you want to make.
Dixon kicks to Lillard. Outside Matthews. Over Williams.
Oh, Wes.
Here's Aldridge. And another shot. Down by Brook Lopez. The Nets have gone 1-3 for the field to start this one so far.
And I thought the key factor was the contribution from the bench.
Oh, you're so true. I mean, a few of those guys came into the game and instantly sparked their offense. You love to see that from the second unit. The D might need to body him up a little better next time. Get into him some.
Yeah, Clark, they need to be a little bit more physical.
You're yeah,
right.
You can't play this game, Saul.
Man, but guys, you got to give him some credit for attacking when he had the chance.
Going back to that trade you're talking about, Clark, several first-round picks and Favors, who has blossomed the last year or two up in Utah.
Devin Harris is okay, well. Wes Matthews is hot. He's got 12 of our 12 points.
While gaining a superstar.
He is hot.
Cheap,
I'm liking it.
I thought the interesting thing about that
is with Matthews hitting jump shots. Oh, we gotta stop him. We can't let Humphreys get them baskets like that. We can't let Humphreys get them.
He would re-sign. So it was really a major gamble at the time.
Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
I had a chance to talk with the head coach for Brooklyn. I asked him what he thought might give them an edge going into this game. They said, well, our shot blocking is always a cornerstone.
There you go.
To have the ability to protect the rim, really, I think, is invaluable and one thing that helps set us apart on the defensive end. Guys, let's see if they can lock down the paint.
Okay, thank you, Doris.
Stubble.
How do you think that'll play out here?
Good deal.
I don't know, Kevin. I'm not sure they should be more focused on their opponent.
I like Humphreys. Give me baskets.
That is sort of the way it sounds, Steve. But still, I don't think a defense-first mindset is ever a bad thing.
Lillard with it, and it's Johnson picking him up. Dixon kicks to Aldridge. Humphreys there. Kicks to Batum. And now here's Johnson, the fast break.
Oh, how about that basketball,
that
man?
Beautiful. Wow.
That's one thing that Jared Waters do.
And that look right there on Clark says it all.
He's not alone, Kevin. Boy, that was just mean right there.
Outside for
Batum. Knock that one down.
And out of bounds as the Nets gain possession. And a moment here to see the standings of the Eastern Conference. And you know, guys, some interesting stories have unfolded here as we move through the middle of the season. If you look at Miami.
Good day.
And of course, there's the Trailblazers tied up with them. Matching up on the changes for Portland. Leonard, he's checked in for Hixon. Luke Babbitt comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge.
Sasha
Pavlovic, she's checked in for Nicholas Batum. And Ronnie Price has subbed in for Lillard.
Oh!
And stolen by Darren Williams.
We'll take that foul.
And the foul called on Myers.
I just want to let this lead slip now. Come on now. This lead slip. Still my step up. Good day. Rebound. Let's go.
The Nets missing. So for the Trailblazers, their last game, a loss to the Jazz in Utah.
And Kevin, they would have had to be sensational defensively to compensate for their lack of offense in that game.
Yeah, and you know what, Steve? I don't think they're built to play those kind of low-scoring, grinded-out games. They weren't that time, at least.
I have no idea why he was fouling there.
And even the foul, I mean, you can't be wrapping guys up like that. I mean, it just doesn't make any sense. That's a meaningless play.
Where's the point? He's scoring in a minute.
He's had his ups and downs in his career, but one thing about Darren Williams is that he consistently delivers.
Ooh, give me the
and
one, baby. Come on, Will.
Knocking down the big shot.
Yeah, and make no mistake about it, Steve. When you talk about Darren Williams, you're talking about a guy who can get it going.
Gunshots outside.
He makes clutch plays, no doubt, but he can put numbers up.
Like they got a shotgun out there.
He can go for half a hunji on you. If you're not careful, his ability to take over games is what makes him a natural leader on the floor, and a guy's teammates have a lot of respect for.
Now here's Williams, an 11-point game for him in the win against Chicago, and it's Lopez penetrating, just five on the clock.
Step up, step up. Good D, good D.
They get it back.
Awesome, thank you.
The Trailblazers have gone 3-for-3 at the line tonight.
Well, impressive free throw shooting as a team this season, right around that 78% mark.
Guys, that says a lot about the poise of this team. I mean, they've been so calm, cool, and consistent at the stripe this year. I mean, that's impressive.
Don't you do that to me, okay.
And both free throws good for Babbitt.
I'm always impressed by big men who shoot free throws as well as he does. For some reason, they're rare.
Johnson, the pass to
Williams. Oh, step up, step up.
The feet to Lopez. LaMarcus Aldridge grabs the miss. Aldridge has got 3 rebounds so far in the game.
There you go, Babbitt. There you go, Babbitt. Let's go.
Now here's Williams. Puts the lead pass in front of him. And they're scoring pretty well.
Humphreys is getting these garbage buckets on me right now, man. I'm not liking that. I'm not liking these buckets that Pushing Call is getting on me. I'm not liking it. And I know why he's getting them. That was stupid. That was my fault. I was hoping he was going to pass it.
Yeah, and I think they're doing a good job gang rebounding too, Steve. Everybody's boxing out down there.
Oh, good defense, Batum.
Second quarter starting for the Nets. Watson out there with Marshawn Brooks. Then it's Blatch. Then there's Bogans. And it's Evans in at the power forward. And Brooklyn has possession, trailing by five. Watson dishes to Bogans. He dishes it to Watson. A three-point
shot. Okay, let him shoot them. Watson can hit them all day long.
Watson's got the second quarter going with the first basket of the period for the Nets. The Trailblazers shooting 43% for the game.
You know, you look back at what's happened to the Blazers over the last few years, it's very sad. This was a club that was poised to be one of the dominant teams in the West, and then the injuries just set them back big time.
I want to go to Aldridge for a jump shot.
Nobody near him. He'll normally make that one.
Feeds it to Bogans.
There's
the screen by Butch. It's Brooks on the wing. He feeds it to Bogans. Watson. And the Nets. Another three.
Injuries
can creep up on a team, and as Steve said, Portland had so much promise just a few years ago, really at the beginning of last season. But look what's happened. No Oden, no Brandon Roy, and he was alluding to that moments ago, Clark, and that's tough. Those were cornerstone pieces for that organization.
Pillars for you, Kevin. It's terribly unfortunate to lose two players of that caliber. You can see why the Blazers basically had to restart.
Back.
Here's Lillard.
There we go.
Follow it.
What a talent.
We gotta watch that on what's it called now. I think you're letting people jump a jump shot.
He gets up so quickly.
It's like a pogo stick.
Oh my gosh, not a lot of point guards in the league can jam like he can.
And he's able to finish, guys, amongst all the big fellas in the paint. Just amazing athleticism.
And the Nets with possession here. The Blazers getting the bucket.
Good defense. God, he can get these threes.
Another one falls.
Ain't necessarily open threes.
Portland trailing. This is their second meeting of the year against this Nets team. There. And Lillard kicks to Alden. He gathers. Oh, the one hand.
Here we go.
An open lane right there. Pretty much saw the daylight he wanted and took advantage.
Yeah, great opportunity, and he sees it without much hesitation.
Yeah, a little too easy, if you ask me.
Good block.
To tighten things up here.
Let's run it.
And it's the Trailblazers on the break.
Jump shot.
Matthews leading the charge.
Get it to go. We needed that.
And Brooklyn will now go the other way with it.
Well, Wes Matthews came in as an undrafted free agent out of Marquette. Not really a household name, but a good two-way player.
I'm out there, man. I'm out there. I'm on that. Sorry, though.
Just going back and forth there. We're seeing some really good basketball.
You know what, guys? I've lost track.
Got lucky. I got lucky on that jump shot.
Changed. I mean, it's obvious, though, it's been a good one. And neither
side can pull away. Lillard's too fast. We dub out there at half court.
Here's Watson, following the score by Damian Lillard. Watson kicks to Evans.
You think he's shooting him with Evans all day.
Time from Batum. And Matthews first signed by the Jazz. But, you know, Portland liked what they saw in him, and they snatched him away with a front-loaded mid-level contract.
Yeah, pretty bold move there. But I think his play has lived up to that investment, and it certainly paid off for him. I mean, to go undrafted, and now he's making more than most of the first-rounders who entered the NBA the same time he did. That's a heck of a move by Matthews.
Mark and Steve, this tug-of-war game continues.
You know what? And they just keep flip-flopping the lead again and again and again. Yeah, how about that last lead change, guys? That's number seven for the game.
Here is Watson, following the score by Damian Lillard.
Oh, my God.
Watson's shot is good. Watson's got 8 points in the quarter.
It looks like he's finding his touch now because the shots are starting to fall. You know, a lot of turnover in the last few years in the front office in Portland. And it's so difficult to make a transition.
Man, so far, even matchup so far.
And get better and improve steadily.
Good day.
When you don't have that continuity upstairs.
Here is Watson, following the basket by LaMarcus Aldridge. And out of bounds as the Trailblazers gain possession.
Let's take a look where J.J. Hickson ranks among the league.
Bench game, shucks.
Sixth in shooting percentage. And he's been a terrific rebounder as well in the top 10 in that category per game.
And Steve, you touched on his outstanding field goal percentage. I mean, he hasn't gotten there.
There you go, Sasha Pavlovich. There you go.
It's also a problem.
All right, where's stretch the lead? Where is stretch? Where is stretch? Where is stretch?
Good open shots.
I'm falling for that.
And as a player, it's hard, you know, sometimes to focus on just playing basketball when things are getting jumbled around upstairs, and there was a lot of jumbling upstairs with the Blazers, unfortunately.
Yeah, that is unfortunate, but it is part of the territory, and these guys are human, even though we think they're robots because of them being professionals. And things are bumpy within the organization. It can make it tough to handle your business between the lines if you're a player.
Shot clock at 6. Here's Pavlovich. Rebounded by the Nets.
Boy, that was way behind the line. Now, he can make that at times.
He certainly is one of the guys that can actually do it from there.
Hogan's passes to Blotch. Brooks outside. He passes to Bogans. Over Leonard. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Nets will retain possession.
Wesley Matthews.
Here's Bogans. And he knocks it down.
That's a nice way to end the half.
Gambling and steal.
Bang. Fortran worth through two here and a good one. Nets lead by 2.
Dang.
We'll see you after halftime for the beginning.
He did better actually with his bench in the game than he did with the starters.
And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. One of the stars here, Wesley Matthews.
Starting to break down a little bit now. Come on now.
You might want to draw up a couple plays for him.
Starting to break down a little.
He's been great from the outside.
Yeah, you know what, Steve? It's like there's nobody else in the gym the way he's shooting. I mean, sometimes you get in that zone from deep, and I'm sure you've known about it and done it.
He's got a nice little first step on.
He's in that Steve Kerr zone.
That's way too deep.
Matthews and Batum on the perimeter. Aldridge out there with Hickson, and it's Lillard in at the point guard. That's the group on the floor for Portland.
We will live with it all day long.
Wallace misses. The Trailblazers shooting has been great, up over 50%. In fact, 52%.
You know, in his day, Gerald Wallace was one of the best athletes in the NBA. I think he's lost a step, but he's still a very explosive player. Ability to get out in transition and just blow by a slower defender.
And here's Johnson outside.
Damn.
Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist.
Well, he did a nice job of getting himself into just enough of an open area to find that spot for his shot.
Time to roll here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. And for Gerald Wallace,
down 3.
Not just sorry,
though. Down 3. It's okay.
And explosiveness at that small forward position. Wow, Clark. Some kind of athlete.
You know, Kevin, he's been one of those guys that can play the four position for you as well, just because of his tenacity and athleticism. He had a season with double-digit rebounds. He plays so big. So that's a valuable asset to have when you've got a guy like Wallace.
Lillard. And it's blocked by Johnson. Gives him the lead pass. Batum with the steal. And here's Matthews, the 3. Wallace with the rebound. Nets leading by 3. Johnson with it. Lillard picks him up. And the basket by Johnson.
That jump shot's like a layup for him when the defense backs off like that.
And this really is such an interesting time for the Nets, because the move to Brooklyn, I think, has elevated the image of that franchise. You know, they used to be the little brothers to the Knicks and playing across the river in New Jersey. But now they basically are sharing the spotlight in the Big Apple, and it's going to be a lot of fun to watch.
And the first timeout called of the game for Brooklyn. Yeah, Nets are now in one of the premier locations, Steve, for any sports franchise, even if it was a short move.
And I saw that shit coming.
With that move, the whole mindset has seemingly changed.
Well, you can certainly call them a big market team now, and a lot of free agents will probably be interested in signing there. So definitely they've got a working
what
in their favor now.
Already it's February. Hard to believe. Let's see how the West is matching up. Take a look at the Spurs and, of course, Portland, just way behind. Here is Watson. 5-point lead, the biggest of the game. Dishes it to Bogans. Here's the 3.
Oh, we got to get them rebounds now.
And they're going to have to make sure they box out here. Don't give up any second chance points.
And that's just too easy. I mean, to rebound effectively, everybody's got to do their part.
The Nets working the ball around.
Good defense.
Now. And again, it's the Nets missing. Trailblazers have gone 2 of 5 shooting here in the third quarter. Outside for Batum. No one near him.
Get it, get hitting him, though.
Brooks outside. He kicks to Bogans. Watch. He's against Hickson. Flash dishes to Bogans. Watch with the screen on Batum. Six on the shot clock. Matthews with the steal. Tries to snap the cold streak.
And the thank you. Good Lord.
Not stop. No way to stop that. I mean, there's nothing you can do when he's coming at him like that.
Well, that's right, Clark.
He's
a dangerous, dangerous player.
Yeah, especially when he gets to that launching pad right there in the lane. I mean, pretty one-handed finish. That was nice.
Back in. Back in. Let's go.
I like that one-handed spike right there.
Yeah, that's how it's done.
Yes, sir-ree.
Yeah, he's not going to miss many of those.
Well, Nicolas Batum out of France, a much coveted young player, and a cornerstone for this Blazer team for the future. Brings together all the things you want to see at that small forward.
I mean, if I hit that, hit the table.
Shooting ability with range and
just stupid substitution.
An almost entirely new group here for Portland. Leonard, he's checked in for Hickson. Luke Babbitt comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. Sasha Pavlovich, she's checked in for Nicolas Batum. And Ronnie Price has subbed in for Lillard.
Oh!
Babbitt's shot is off. And Nick Batum, a player who's long and athletic, as Steve was talking about, still very young. We know he can already score, Clark, in the NBA. He is a wonderful prospect.
Well, you always look at Lillard.
We'll take them all day.
That's an asset coaches and teams like to have. So, tremendous defensive potential there. He could develop into a scary two-way player.
3 seconds separate the shot clock.
I'm sure about taking one on one.
There's the foul. It's on Richie Evans. That's his first foul. Now, here's Lillard. Defense right on him. Pass to Batum. The dish to Price. The Trailblazers need to get off a shot. Offensive rebound for the lead. And the rejection by Platch. And the game still.
Now one. Start the fourth. Let's go, baby.
Portland trailing here. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the fourth quarter. Setting the floor for the Nets. Gerald Wallace, Chris Humphries, and Brook Lopez.
There we go. They knocked it down.
Darren Williams.
They knocked it down. Oh, shit.
What a great game. This looks like it's going to go right down to the wire.
Well, you talk about what happens in close games. Mistakes are magnified.
Even that, come on.
Very careful down the stretch here.
Boy, I love watching Darren Williams play. Guys, he's one of the best point guards in the game, both in terms of getting to the free throw line and in his free throw percentage. So if you let him break down your defense and draw fouls, you're in big trouble.
And back to Darren Williams and his free throw shooting and all those attempts.
There you go.
That's a big key.
All right, what's Matthews?
Great consistency on offense.
You heat up. Yeah, you in between the heat up.
You start out cold. You know, you're able to use the ability to get to the line to get himself
short. Let's go.
Put some points on the board. Typically, he's pretty dependable on those open jump shots.
And Matthews throws it down.
Way to weave through there. Way to weave through there.
Aggressiveness finishing inside like that.
Well, his leaping ability, Clark, gives him a great advantage.
And that's why they look to get him the ball around.
Good
the rim.
D.
I mean, it feels like it's either a dunk
or get a rebound
foul
back.
And a couple of free throws every possession.
Out to Wallace. Johnson left side. Takes the three.
Short.
And Johnson missing again. And it's Brook Lopez.
Let's capitalize.
That'll be his second foul of the game.
Let's go.
A little overeager right there. Left his feet too early.
And if you're already boxed out, you got to try to work to get around. Otherwise, it's a surefire foul.
Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
Yes, I had a chance to find out what the Trailblazers head coach was going over with his guys. It's been a hard-fought game, and he just wanted to give his guys a chance to catch their breath, saying, listen, we're right there.
Yes, let's go.
Push right here.
Dang, but two more got 4 points? Wow.
Kevin?
Well, you hate to see a guy suffer through a game like this, but his team is winning.
Williams kicks the Lopez. Flushes it down.
And the thing I admire about him is his poise. He just always looks cool and composed.
Beat that double every time.
Doesn't matter if it's the first quarter or the fourth quarter. He's got that same expression on his face.
Don't beat that double every time.
The second thing I want to bring up about him is his top-notch play.
What's he called? Lillard. Don't beat that double every time. Don't double that high.
The moves he shows off.
Williams double team. Lillard comes with the double team. Here's Johnson.
Oh, crap. Oh.
They get it back. Humphries kicks to Johnson. And there's the rejection. Out of bounds. Next ball as Brooklyn keeps possession. And the Trailblazers making a change here. Babbitt's checked in.
Crossbar. Oh, he's cold. He's cold.
Team Johnson passes it to Williams. Leads him in there. And Brook Lopez, the bucket on the assist by Williams.
Bucket inside.
6 points for Brook Lopez.
But they haven't been getting lit up from outside here. All the points they're giving up are from in close. They've got to offer more resistance.
Yeah, defense has to get better, Clark. They've got to body up, bump somebody, get physical, force the action back out to the perimeter.
Here's Matthews. The shot misses.
You know, typically, guys, he has the body control to finish when he's in that tight. I'm not sure what happened there.
Johnson.
That was a smart shot. Get him out of cold.
Looks like he's starting to get things going here after that scoreless first half.
Lillard, the pass to Matthews. The pass to Lillard. Kicks it to Aldridge. Humphries there. Outside for Batum. Snatched up. And Lillard gets the
Gets
the point of the fall. Matthews has got 9 points now in the quarter.
Go, Wesley Matthews, step out there.
It's already been a great day for him.
Oh, yeah.
Johnson can't get it to go.
Nothing's working for him here. He's just really struggling to find the basket.
Oh, why did he shoot?
Wallace. And now in transition, here's Williams. Here we go. That's good from Johnson on the assist by
Williams. God, I can't put this guy away.
Williams has got assist number 7 for him tonight. Portland leading. Here's Lillard. The monster one-hand slam.
You got Lillard out there, baby. We call timeout. We need more guys to rest right quick.
Absolutely, we're seeing more and more of that kind of explosiveness. In fact, the point guard now has never been as prominent and as important, I think, in the game that it is right now.
Some of that is the rule changes, guys. No hand checks. The floor is more spread. But yeah, this new breed of athletic point
guard. Got too deep.
So exciting.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. KJ Hickson, he's checked in for Portland.
Dang, that's a good day.
We've got 108 left in the fourth quarter of this one. And Batum kicks to Matthews. The feed now to Lillard. The baseline J.
Ooh, I needed that. I needed that. I'm glad he hit that. So glad he hit that.
How about what a game? I mean, he answered the bell with that one.
They double-team Johnson. They double him with Matthews. And Williams, here we go. Lopez. And the call will be against LaMarcus Aldridge.
Oh, man, why are we fouling? Why are we fouling? Why are we fouling right there?
Williams kicks to Johnson to take the lead.
Dang, this motherfucker caught fire. Shit.
I'll tell you what, it's a scary sight when Johnson starts lighting it up like this.
Lillard. And again, it's the Trailblazers from deep.
Incredible. Only took them a few seconds to answer the three ball with one of their own.
Let's keep this thing going, guys. I love seeing a three-point battle like this.
Double team on Williams. LaMarcus Aldridge grabs the miss. Portland's gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. And they commit an intentional
foul. The ball with Matthews. The ball with Matthews.
Yeah, you got to freeze the clock. I mean, that's the enemy in this situation.
A few misses at the line, and they're in good shape.
And he commits the intentional foul. He hits the first one, and that makes it a three-point lead. So he gets them both.
All right, let's go.
Four-point ball game.
Thanks to those free throws right there, it becomes a two-possession game.
I don't want no overtimes. No overtimes. I do not want overtime. Defense, please.
15 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
Well, the way to go
we're
here,
double net. We're double team net.
And then a foul. That's the only course of action at this point.
And it's key who they
have. Yes.
Don't send the next three throws.
Here we go. Yes.
And now they foul and stop the clock. Two shots. Drops the first one, and that puts them up by 5.
Second one is good.
Let's go. Ooh-wee. It's a 6-point ball game. Oh man, pull this one out.
Free throws there. You can put this one in the books.
Here's Williams. Can't get it to fall. And so it's Portland winning this one. They came. 6-4. The Nets.